Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding clarity and facts on the ground written by Suhirth Parthasarathy. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2 plus. This is important for political science and public administration optional students. Now first of all, what is the context of this editorial? This editorial is about how Indian judiciary is abstaining from its duty to adjudicate and how this is leading to the executive and the legislative despotism. So this is about legislative despotism. Now first of all, we need to understand what is meant by legislative despotism. Now legislative despotism means that legislature is disregarding the fundamental rights that have been accorded to the citizens of India, and it is not taking into consideration the rights of the people, and without taking into consideration the rights of the people, it is just adjudicating. It is adjudicating on the matters at its own convenience. Now this is a very important thing, at its own convenience. Now first of all, we must understand the reason why the judiciary has been created. Now the purpose and the intent of the creation of the judiciary was to adjudicate on the important matters, on the matters that involves the element of justice. Whenever you knock at the door of the judiciary, judiciary must respond, and judiciary must respond at the earliest, because there's an important saying that justice delayed is justice buried. Now if you will be delaying the justice, it will be just like burying the justice. Justice delayed is justice denied. So this is the second saying. So judiciary must first of all try to prioritize what are the important areas, because if judiciary will not be prioritizing the areas, in that case legislature, by implementing certain policies, will be thwarting the fundamental rights of the people. Judiciary, if it will be delaying its adjudication process, it will not be able to scrutinize whether the policies, whether the programs, whether the laws that the legislature is coming out with, whether they stand to the spirit and the value system of the Indian constitution or not. Now we have two cases, important cases, which are yet to be adjudicated upon, but they have already been implemented. Now even if the Supreme Court will be calling these two legislations as ultra vires to the constitution, or they that are in negation to the Indian constitution, still nothing much could be done about those illegal legislations, ultra vires legislations, because they have already been implemented. Do aisi legislations hai. Sabse important legislation hai demonetization ki. And second is the legislation about Aadhaar Act. The government, it has already implemented demonetization, but the case is still pending in the judiciary. Judiciary has not adjudicated upon this case. Now such kind of attitude by the judiciary, such kind of conduct by the judiciary is not good for the Indian constitution, and it is also not good for the fundamental rights protection in India. So what judiciary should actually be doing? Judiciary needs to prioritize which cases are more important and which cases will have a sudden impact on the life of the people. Now, with respect to Aadhaar Bill, Aadhaar Act, if the judiciary will be adjudicating upon it later on, and if it will be coming out with a verdict like the right to privacy is very important and cardinal right, and whatever the government has done with respect to Aadhaar Act by making it compulsory in order to have access to the welfare scheme's benefits, in that case, the policy would have already been implemented. The policy would have already been used. So it is important for the judiciary either to put stay on such policies or to adjudicate upon such policies at the earliest. Now, with respect to Aadhaar Act, judiciary has not stayed the implementation of Aadhaar Act, and judiciary had also not stayed the implementation of the demonetization exercise that the government has executed. Na to judiciary ne iske upar stay lagaya, na hi judiciary ne iske upar stay lagaya. Agar judiciary stay nahi lagati hai, us case mein aapka adjudication process jaldi hona chahiye. Na to adjudication jaldi ho raha hai, na to judiciary ye bata rahi hai ki ye jo law hai, Aadhaar Act bana hai, it is in consonance with the Indian Constitution or not. Na to ye bataya ja raha hai, na hi iske upar stay diya ja raha hai. And government legislature kya kar raha hai, aisi policies ko jaldi jaldi laake jaldi jaldi implement kar raha hai. And this is leading to legislative despotism. Ek jo balance hona chahiye, like the balance between the executive, judiciary and the legislature, this balance is actually disturbed by the judiciary, because judiciary remains in slumber, judiciary remains dormant. So what we need is the activism on the part of judiciary. What we need is the prioritization on the part of the judiciary. Judiciary really needs to look at the cases from the perspective of priority, that if it will be adjudicating later on, if it will be delaying its adjudication, what implications it would have on the Indian politic fabric. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in joining the classes offline or online. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.